This is the world's first self-driving mobility device.
Welcome to the future.
It has 2 Lidars, 6 ultrasonic sensors, 12 time-of-flight sensors, and 2 visual cameras so it doesn't bump into anything. Plus, it can be driven all around your house with just your voice.
Where are your hands at? You're not even doing anything?
I'm not touching anything.
This power chair is named the EV1 from a company called Strut.
No hands, Mom?
EV meaning everyday vehicle.
And there's the fridge.
Arrived at the destination.
Yes, we have.
And with its LiDAR cameras and sensors, it's closer in the evolutionary chain to a smart car than it is to a mobility aid.
Strut has given us early access and permission to share our thoughts on this prototype, but even we won't know the price until the end of this video.
I can think of so many things I could do hands-free in my chair. Text and drive. I could read a book. I could eat a sandwich. There's a lot. The possibilities are endless when you have both your hands free.
Take me to the Christmas tree.
Heading to Christmas tree.
Have you ever been able to eat and drive at the same time?
No, not on my own. That was wild.
Watch out for the table.
It did.
That's insane.
With nearly 20 sensors around the outside of the chair, it's like impossible to crash into anything. Watch this. I can't hit that chair. Which, like, you know, I don't want to name names, but there are, you know, other drivers in this house with manual chairs. But let's just say the baseboards and the cabinets will never be the same. So it's nice that the chair has co-pilot, which avoids walls and obstacles all by itself.
It's not just the baseboards that get damaged. My hand gets smashed too. Probably because my manual chair doesn't have LiDAR. You might be like, hey Jerry, what even is LiDAR?
LiDAR is a super high-tech remote sensor that uses pulsed laser light to measure distances and create super precise 3D maps to find objects, like walls, steps, or furniture. It's like sonar for robots, and since it generates its own light with invisible laser beams, it can operate in complete darkness. It's pretty impressive stuff, and this EV1 has 2 of them. Each of the front 2 wheels has its own lighthouse of LiDAR on top.
You can even tell the door is open on the elevator. That's crazy. That's so cool. Backing up. This is like driving a car inside the house. Coming in here to the living room. Everything just appears on the map in real time. Look at that Christmas tree. Holy smokes. You can see it on the screen.
It even differentiates my feet, which is especially helpful for people who walk near the EV1 so they don't get accidentally run over. Objects in purple are moving, gray objects are static, and stairs or cliffs are marked with yellow and orange.
So there are 3 ways you can drive the EV1. The first is manually with this joystick right here. The second is using their waypoint system where you can just use a voice command to take you where you want to. And then the third way is Pathfinder. So you long press on your map here and it'll take you to where you want to go.
We've seen it navigate the indoors, but what about the outdoors? The Strut EV1 has 3.1 inches of ground clearance and a quad drive system, meaning that there is a motor inside each of the tires. And since these tires are much larger than the front casters of a regular manual wheelchair, it means we can conquer some more aggressive obstacles.
So can you fall off a cliff?
If I go into manual mode, but the co-pilot won't allow me to. Even though I was injured in a horse accident, horses are still a big part of my life.
I know, I'm a little slow, huh?
Probably because it's quiet and small, my horses don't appear to be afraid of the EV1. Horses might look big and scary, but they can be really skittish.
Yeah, he's gonna go look for hay or for grass somewhere.
Since I've already set the stall for the waypoint, I'm gonna use voice command to get me there since my hands are overflowing with carrots. Take me to the stall.
What the?
Still can't get over this.
Come on, Link. I want to stall.
I can't believe you're not using your hands right now.
It's crazy. I'm not using my hands. It's outside. It's my own terrain. Has it mapped out. It's wild. There are obstacles.
Let's see how it handles the shaving. Nice.
We made it!
Arrived at the destination.
It's just the EV1. The everyday vehicle. Take me to the middle of the paddock.
Heading to middle of paddock.
What's that?
I feel like a queen right now, getting carried to the next place.
What's that kid show, Wally?
Yes, that's glorious though. It's so glorious.
To be fair, they weren't carrying carrots though.
This is more high tech, I think.
Arrived arrived at the destination.
Hi.
Got no more carrots. It's hard to explain it to somebody that hasn't experienced it before, but going over grass or gravel or dirt requires quite a bit of energy, kind of like walking on the sand. And my like human battery depletes over time as I'm trying to push over that different terrain.
That's really cool.
Whereas the EV1, it allows me to maneuver terrains like this without depleting my internal battery.
The more we drive it, the more I'm realizing how big of a deal this is. Like, LiDAR has been around for a really long time. Like, we've had it in vacuum cleaners for years, but for some reason in the accessibility or the mobility space, they're usually like a decade behind. And it's not like an emotional experience, but it kind of is almost an emotional experience.
Yeah, because like I love my vacuum. I think it's a great accessory and I love my vehicle that has some of these features, but the fact that it's in a device that you can use every day and just makes your daily activities easier, it's life-changing. And I'm just grateful that it's come into the accessibility world.
I'm a fan of how easy the EV1 is to disassemble. The whole chair weighs about 130 pounds when fully built, but breaks down into 5 modular parts that are much easier to place in a car, and much easier for Strut to add accessories onto in the future. The whole chair can be broken down in about 3 minutes and reassembled in about the same amount of time, each piece just clipping together like little Legos. On top of being modular, they also have labeled tools on the inside for on-the-go adjustments. These just sit right down underneath the cushion. Perfect.
This lever here pulls this back, makes space for me to transfer in.
It looks so futuristic compared to your chair now. Look at all the
tech
on there.
That's like luxury versus, I mean, I do like this.
Right.
But this is like a whole different breed.
Yeah, it's the Lambo of accessible devices. Okay, and then what, you drop that armrest back down?
Yeah, it's like 2 steps. This down, you're ready to go. Grass is never a friend of mine in a manual wheelchair. Some of the harder terrain I've been on is grass, gravel, and cobblestone. Cobblestone's the worst. I have to be in a wheelie the entire time I'm on it.
Didn't even strut.
Woo! I've tried some other motorized vehicles out on the grass and I was worried I was gonna tip over because it's just like unpredictable ground, like a little hilly here and flatter here and the grass is longer here than there. Other vehicles haven't done this bit of a job.
So Cambry, for some reason, everyone has left their shoes out on the floor and Cambry's gonna see if the EV1 can take her to the elevator.
Navigate without hitting my shoes.
The elevator is in that far room around the corner.
Take me to the elevator.
Heading to elevator.
Oh, not bad. That's tight. Oh, it's changing its mind.
Precision.
Oh, it's going over here. Oh, wow. Ooh.
This is a party.
Is it gonna back you up?
I don't know, but I think it's cool.
It's getting the perfect angle.
Believe in you, EV1.
There we go. Hey!
That's
cool.
So cool.
All right. She's going no hands still, huh?
Still hands free.
That's insane. You can text and drive.
Text and drive.
Okay, so this is the
waypoint. The destination.
It spoke before I could. This is the destination. So Cambry has to take over and go in manually from here. Hey.
Okay.
Nice. I can't believe it fits.
She's in nice and tight.
You wanna try going up?
Yeah. This isn't hands-free. Works in her house.
Back it up, Terry.
Okay.
It's pretty impressive how small it is. As far as charging goes, this battery is removable. Just like that. But I imagine most people are just gonna wanna plug in right there, which the battery connection looks like this. And there we go, plugged in and ready to rock.
Anytime I click the button on the joystick, it goes into co-pilot plus mode, which does the thinking for me and avoids obstacles, like humans in these aisles.
So in this situation, I'm trying to get something off the shelf and I'm gonna use co-pilot plus to avoid obstacles like Zach, who's taking up the entire aisle, but still maintaining a forward motion. Oh, there's a grocery cart here. It's gonna maneuver around it without me even having to think about it. Almost hit those people, but co-pilot didn't let me.
So in this case, I could be looking at the shelves and not have to be looking at the people, which is great, way more efficient for my grocery trip. EV1 can even help me make cookies. So I just ask it, what ingredients do I need to make chocolate chip cookies?
Here are the common ingredients you'll need to make chocolate chip cookies: all-purpose flour, baking soda, salt, unsalted butter, granulated sugar, brown sugar, eggs, vanilla extract, chocolate chips. Would you like a full recipe or help finding these ingredients in your environment?
That's so crazy.
I never had a power chair do that before.
So here we have the headlights in the front. There's a time of flight here, a vision camera here. The main players obviously are the lidars, which give us a 360 degree view of the surroundings. And then the ultrasonics are these circles right here. And the reason there's such a variety is because the ultrasonics are able to detect clear things like glass. And so where, you know, lidar would be able to see through the glass and vision sees through glass, ultrasonic would stop if you ever came to a screen door or like the polycarbonate on our elevator. Different sensors for different things.
To see the whole picture, obviously.
While the EV1 does have quad motors and can handle off-road situations, it definitely feels most at home on pavement and urban surfaces. And of course, a glimpse of what Cambry and I are going to look like when we're 80, rolling off into the sunset. It's fitting that the EV1 will be officially launching at CES this year, and it's already won the CES Best of Innovations Award for 2026 and the Red Dot Luminary Award of 2025, which brings us to the price.
So Cambry, now that you've lived with the EV1 for a day, what are your thoughts?
I really like it. I could probably ramble on about all the things I like about it. The feature that I really love is the co-pilot, because it navigates my surroundings without me worrying about my fingers getting smashed or my house getting destroyed from my vehicle, essentially. So I love that. But what I think is really unique to this smart function and the high-tech piece to it is that it's so user-friendly. Like, I needed a 2-minute tutorial and I was confident. It's smart, but it's made for anyone, I feel like.
And when it comes to price, what price do you think? And not many people know this, but Cambry has a master's degree in occupational therapy, so she has experience in more ways than one. But in your expert opinion, what do you think the price of the EV1 is?
When I stack it up to other things that exist on the market, I feel like it's probably gonna be like $17,000?
What is it? That's about what I thought as well. So I know the price now. And you're gonna be surprised to hear that it's only $5,000.
No way.
$299 at launch.
Yeah, that's wild.
That's insane.
That's what like a dumb chair is.
Yeah, a manual chair. More people pay more than that for their manual chair. It's incredible. And there's more. As a thank you for testing out their prototype version, they want to give you one for free when the official one launches.
No way!
Yeah, it's super cool.
Like, I got emotional. That's really sweet.
It's fun. So I'm floored by the price, but I'm also super excited for the future because all the hardware is there in the thing, and like the Strut team was talking about how they want to implement Apple Vision Pro so people can drive it using just their eyes. And like, that's such a huge deal. So
yeah,
the future's here. And if you want more information, I will leave a link down in the video description.
Thanks a ton for watching.
We'll see you around.